Centro City Councilman is seeking re-election after a criminal conviction. He tells us why, despite that, he is still equipped to serve. Gianella Giglino reports.
Jason Jackson has been working for the city of El Centro for almost a decade. Jackson spent 4 years as an El Centro planning commissioner before being elected to the El Centro City Council in 2011. He was re-elected in 2015 and in 2016 served as pro tem mayor. He is the president and CEO of Southwest Protective Services, Inc., where he employs more than 125 local security officers in the Imperial and Coachella Valleys. Jackson's decision to rerun for council came from the fact that he had already served in council during the pandemic.
Now's not the time to be making changes. We're still in the midst of the pandemic. We are currently seeing an economic downturn with the closure of a lot of our businesses. Unemployment is up. And I think experience and a steady hand is what is needed for the next 4 years to help El Centro recover.
Jackson says he still has a lot of projects to complete.
That we haven't gotten to the end yet. In my first term, one of my objectives was to get a department built for the city of El Centro, and then also a new library.
Jackson has also been the center of controversy several times. He was charged with felony animal cruelty, which ended up becoming a misdemeanor and led to him serving 10 days in jail. Earlier this year, he was caught violating his probation by receiving 2 speeding tickets.
All those things that I faced, whatever my opinion is of them or whatever anybody else is, never affected my ability to run this city and to make a positive mark on the city of El Centro. And so, that's a chapter that is behind me. It will officially be behind me in about 4 more days. And, I'm just looking to the future. I'm looking to, people that want to dwell in the past, I'm gonna allow them to dwell in the past. For me, I'm looking at the future.
There are 3 seats available for the El Centro City Council. Reporting in El Centro, Gianella Giglino, News 11.